Hi, my name is Abby Lynch and I'm the Teen Services Librarian here at the Brookfield Library, back for another week of Teen Book Talks. Today is the last day of our summer reading program, so hopefully you had fun doing the bingo sheets over the course of the summer. You still have 1 week to return any completed bingo sheets to be entered for the raffle. You can drop those off at the circulation desk or outside, and there's a labeled box for the Teen Summer Reading bingo sheets. And you can drop those off there, and then we'll draw the prizes on the 23rd, Monday of the week after. And this week we're going to talk about survival stories. It's a scorcher out here today that I'm recording, and I'm thinking, man, I'm so grateful for air conditioning. These stories are not like that. These stories are kids braving the wilderness, getting themselves out of some tricky situations, showing off their survival skills, and I hope you're along for their harrowing journeys. As always, you can check these books out from the library in person, or by placing a hold online at brookfieldlibrary.org, or by calling 203-775-6241 and we'll help you out. We also have curbside pickup available still. Some of the books today are available on Hoopla and I will mention them when they are. And let's get started. First up today, we have Prepped by Bethany Mangle. Always be ready for the worst day of your life. This is the mantra that Becca Aldane has grown up with. Her family is part of a community of doomsday preppers, a neighborhood that prioritizes survivalist training over class trips or senior prom. They're even arranging Becca's marriage with Roy Kang, the only eligible boy in their community. Roy is a nice guy, but he's so enthusiastic about prepping that Becca doesn't have the heart to tell him she's planning to leave as soon as she can earn a full ride to a college far, far away. Then, a devastating accident rocks Becca's family and pushes the entire community, including Becca's usually cynical little sister, deeper into the doomsday ideology. With her getaway plans thrown into jeopardy, the only person Becca can turn to is Roy, who reveals that he's not nearly as clueless as he's been pretending to be. When Roy proposes they run away together, Becca will have to risk everything, including her heart, for a chance to hope for the best instead of planning for the worst. So that's Prepped by Bethany Mangle. Next up is a book by a Connecticut author. It's Damselfly by Chandra Prasad. In the wake of crash landing on a deserted tropical island, a group of private school teens must rely on their wits and one another to survive. Having just survived a plane crash, Samantha Mishra finds herself isolated and injured in the thick of the jungle. She has no idea where she is or where anybody else is. She doesn't even know if anybody else is alive. Once Sam connects with her best friend Mel and they locate the others, they set up camp and hope for rescue. But as the days pass, the survivors, all teammates on the Drake Rosemont fencing team, realize that they're on their own, with the exception of a mysterious presence who taunts and threatens them. When their initial attempts to escape the island fail, the teens find they need to survive more than the jungle. They need to survive each other. And that's also available as an audiobook on Hoopla, and that's Damselfly by Chandra Prasad. If you like your survival stories with a little bit of humor, you should try I Have a Bad Feeling About This by Jeff Strand. Wilderness Survival Tip 1. Drinking your own sweat will not save your life. Somebody might have told you that, but they were trying to find out if you'd really do it. Henry Lambert would rather play video games than spend time in the great outdoors, but that doesn't make him a wuss. Skinny nerd, fine, but wuss is a little harsh. Sadly, his dad doesn't agree, which is why Henry is being shipped off to Strongwoods Survival Camp. Strongwoods isn't exactly as advertised. It looks like the victim of a zombie apocalypse, and the camp director is a psycho drill sergeant, and Henry's sure he saw a sign written in blood. Wilderness survival tip number 2. In case of an avalanche, don't despair. You're doomed, but that's a wicked cool death. Wilderness survival tip number 3. If you're relying on this book for actual survival tips, you're dead already. And this is also available as an ebook on Hoopla, and that's I Have a Bad Feeling About This by Jeff Strand. Next up we have Wildfire by Carrie Mack. Annie and Pete have been best friends since they were little. They know each other better than anyone, and they've been on more adventures than they can count. They even have a notebook filled with all the times they've almost died. But they always survive because together they're invincible. And they've always been just friends. But lately, Annie has been thinking that maybe friendship is just the beginning and she's been mentally replaying all the times they were almost something more. Now they're heading out on their next great quest, a 10-day backpacking trip through the mountains of Washington State, ending at fire camp, where they'll learn to fight the area's growing wildfire problem. The woods spark with the promise of adventure, but a freak climbing accident interrupts their progress, and as the wildfires close in and smoke envelops them, Annie and Pete wander farther from the trail. So that's Wildfire by Carrie Mack. And last up today, we have 96 Miles by J.L. Esplin. Dad always said if things get desperate, it's okay to drink the water in the toilet. I never thought it would come to that. I thought I'd sooner die than let one drop of toilet water touch my lips. Yet here I am, kneeling before a porcelain throne, holding a tin mug for scooping in one hand and my half-gallon canteen in the other. The Lockwood brothers are supposed to be able to survive anything. Their dad, a hardcore survivalist, has stockpiled enough food and water on their isolated Nevada ranch to last for months. But when they are robbed at gunpoint during a massive blackout while their dad is out of town, John and Stu must walk 96 miles in the stark desert sun to get help. And they only have 3 days before their time runs out. Those are our books for today. If you are not a survival story fan, please fill out a request for a personalized reading list or a super secret book bag, and we'll be happy to pull some books that you like better. If you are a survival story fan and you read any of these, I'd love to hear what you end up thinking of them. Please return your bingo sheets before the 23rd so that we can draw our raffle prizes. Until next time, have a great week.